India generated over 771,000 tons of e-waste in 2018 and 19. Next year, the figure rose 32% to 1.14 million tons. Fast forward a year ahead, and India is now officially the world's third largest e-waste generator, producing over 3.23 million metric tons of e-waste per year. Jamshedpur, or Tatanagar, was India's first planned industrial city and continues to be an industrial hub. It is a city amenable to new rules and regulations that improve public services. It takes pride in being a trendsetter in this regard. So the city administration decided to take the initiative to deal with their e-waste in a better manner. Let us understand how the authorities manage Jamshedpur's e-waste and why awareness about the matter is equally important. A city built around the century-old Tata steel industry, Jamshedpur generates half a ton of e-waste per day. Before 2018, hundreds of local kabadiwalas and recyclers used to collect e-waste and burn it to extract valuable metals from it. During the process, they would expose themselves and the environment to toxic fumes and chemicals. This was an unsustainable situation.
यहाँ के लोग काफी स्वच्छता को लेकर के और सफाई को लेकर के काफी सजग हैं क्योंकि आप जानते हैं कि जब टाटा जी ने इसका एस्टेब्लिशमेंट किया था तब से लेकर के आज तक लोगों के अवेयरनेस में काफी बढ़ोतरी हुई है और खास करके ई वेस्ट जो है एक नया चीज हम लोगों के द्वारा ई वेस्ट कलेक्शन सेंटर बनाया गया है जो कि हम लोगों ने करीब 4 साल पहले इसकी जो है आगाज किया था और इसको हम लोग जो है रिसाइकलिंग के लिए हम लोग कलकत्ता भेजते हैं बेंगलोर भेजते हैं और हम लोगों ने एक कंपनी हायर किया है होलाडे के माध्यम से हम जो भी ई वेस्ट कलेक्शन यहाँ पे निकलता है उसको हम लोग कलेक्शन करते हैं प्रोसेस करते हैं और फिर उसको रिसाइकलिंग करके हम लोग पुनः फिर उसको यूज करवाने के लिए मार्केट में लाते हैं
ऑन June 5th 2019 आफ्टर गेटिंग अ गो अहेड फ्रॉम द स्टेट पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड and completing logistical formalities, Huladek started its full-fledged operation in Jamshedpur at a warehouse allotted by Jamshedpur Utility Service Company, JUSCO.
We are an electronic and electrical waste management producer responsibility organization. Our job is to collect electronic and electrical waste from across the country and channelize it to recyclers of the same on behalf of producers. We have about 50 odd producers working with us right now and 10 recyclers across the country. So this entire process of collection and channelization to the recycler as per the law is done on behalf of the producers. Now who are the producers? Producers are essentially the brand owners or manufacturers of electronics who are selling new electronics in the market. So as per the rule, it is their responsibility to ensure that when they sell products, when that product becomes end of life or becomes e-waste, it needs to be properly collected and recycled. Common brands such as smartphone brands or consumer durable brands are responsible for this and they fund organizations like ourselves to do this on their behalf. This center also is run for many of one such brands that we work with.
The staff of the e-waste management center at Birupa Road collects e-waste in 4 ways. Monthly door-to-door collection is carried out by 2 dedicated Huladek e-rickshaws. Each of them accompanied by 2 staff members for collection and for raising awareness about safe e-waste practices. Apart from this, about 80 vehicles that belong to the city administration also collect e-waste in a segregated manner while collecting other wastes. During the awareness campaign, many institutes became interested in the cause of managing e-waste better and agreed to work as local drop-off points for e-waste, where people associated with them could deposit their e-waste. There are 5 such e-waste collection centers in Jamshedpur. the largest quantity of e-waste comes from bulk waste generators. The list of bulk waste generators in Jamshedpur is long and it contains names not limited to the Tata group of companies. A toll-free number has also been provided where citizens can reach out to schedule a pickup of e-waste.
हम लोग पास दो सालों से जुस्को के साथ में जमशेदपुर में काम कर रहे हैं बेसिकली ई वेस्ट की अलग अलग कैटेगरीज होती है सबसे पहले आता है आईटी इक्विपमेंट्स आईटी में आपके आते हैं प्रिंटर्स कंप्यूटर्स सीपीयूस उसके बाद आता है कंज्यूमर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स जिसमें आपके घर के सामान हो गए एसी हो गया फ्रिज हो गया तीसरा आता है इंडस्ट्रियल आइटम्स इंडस्ट्रियल आइटम्स में जैसे आपने देखा होगा लाइट फिटिंग्स जितनी इंडस्ट्रीज में लगी होती है उसके अलावा कंप्रेसर्स होते हैं एक और कैटेगरी होती है बैटरी के तो बैटरी में दो टाइप होते हैं लेड एसिड और जो ड्राई सेल होता है तो वो भी हम लोग लेते हैं और रिसाइकल करते हैं ई वेस्ट में प्रॉब्लम सबसे ज़्यादा ये आती है कि लोगों को पता नहीं है कि ये हजार्डियस है कि नहीं बेसिकली कोई भी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक चीज़ जो होती है उसमें कुछ ना कुछ हजार्डियस होता है जैसे मरकरी होता है कैडियम होता है लेड होता है तो वो आपके एनवायरनमेंट को हार्म कर सकती है सपोज एक अगर सीआरटी जो बॉक्स वाला टीवी होता है उसमें लेड होता है तो अगर आप एक लोकल वेंडर को उसको देते हो तो वो उसको सेग्रीगेट करके जो प्रेशियस आइटम है वो निकाल लेता है बट जो लेड होता है उसको वो बाहर फेंक देता है जिससे सॉइल वाटर पोल्यूशन और एयर पोल्यूशन हो सकता है हमारी जैसी कंपनीज उसको एक अच्छे तरीके से रिसाइकलिंग करती है जिसमें एनवायरनमेंट को डैमेज नहीं होता
ओवरऑल 230 टन्स ऑफ ई वेस्ट हैज बीन कलेक्टेड टिल डेट 95.5 tons in 2021 alone. The e-waste management center has a capacity of 35 tons. Once enough waste has been accumulated at the center, it is transported to the Kolkata warehouse of Huladek that has a capacity of 160 tons. In general, the transfer of waste from Jamshedpur to the Kolkata warehouse takes place once a month. The story of e-waste does not end here. After transportation to the warehouse, Huladek sends the e-waste to six recyclers authorized by the Central Pollution Control Board. We met one of these recyclers to understand how each item of waste is carefully broken down into its parts. Just Dispose Private Limited is a recycler operating from Vasai, near Mumbai. Just Dispose is a single point of contact for meeting all obligations under EPR laws, as per CPCB. With a strong collection system, a reverse logistics mechanism, an in-house recycling facility to recycle e-waste, plastic waste, precious metal recovery, and a robust reporting system for documentation, the company ensures scientific processing and disposal of waste.
India is a developing country and we have a very good population. So the potential of this e-waste generation is much, much higher. Whatever generation of gold, gold production, out of that 30-40% of gold is used in electronics item, gold, silver, whether any precious metal. So we can recover that precious metal back. All these metals has its own value. Along with that, some hazardous materials are also there in the electronics. Some chemicals are there used at the time of manufacturing it. So that is also to be channelized and properly dispose it off. Otherwise, it's dangerous for human health. So when we bring material to our facilities, so we wait, we make a record, then we segregate it in a commodity wise. Suppose whether it is a IT equipment, whether it is white goods or all. Then we check that whether this material can be reused or not. If material is not usable, non-repairable, then we do recycling.
At the Just Dispose plant, an electronic item is first manually dismantled and segregated according to the type of elements they are composed of. Generally, parts are divided into ferrous metals, non-ferrous metals, and plastics. There are separate sections to process and recycle these after they are segregated. For example, plastics are shredded and mixed to be sold to different manufacturers and used as alternative fuel in cement factories. Copper is separated and stripped into wires. One of the most intricate processes is extracting thin copper wires from printed circuit boards that are found in computers. The copper is converted into ingots for reuse, while fiber boards they were embedded on are used in tile manufacturing. There are separate machines to recover precious metals like gold and silver, which are eventually sold. Jamshedpur authorities have understood their target audience and focused on institutions like schools, industrial units, the Chamber of Commerce, etc. to good effect. Jamshedpur Utility Service Company's tie-up with Huladec has been beneficial to both the entities and ensures that the city's e-waste is collected and recycled in a smooth and efficient manner. Involvement of producer responsibility organizations in the management of e-waste is an easily replicable practice, as it comes at zero cost to urban local bodies while ensuring adherence to the e-waste management rules of 2016.
अभी हम लोगों को फ्यूचर में और भी प्लान है कि e-waste collection center को decentralized तरीके से और भी करीब 5-7 सेंटर और भी बनाने की योजना है और लोगों को घर तक ही हम लोग सोच रहे हैं कि उसके लोकैलिटी में ही हम लोग ये चीज सेंटर प्रोवाइड करें ताकि लोगों को इतना दूर आने की आवश्यकता नहीं पड़ेगी.
So one more thing, as an industry that I think everyone will agree with me, we are very proud of, is the fact that we've managed to change consumer behavior towards habits of recycling. The EPR model, or the producers being involved, actually made the business and the overall environment quite sustainable.